everyone, it's Amber Spotted Elk at the Paper Owl, and welcome to my channel. Today we are going to be doing a craft room organization challenge hosted by Sammy at Unicorn Dust Designs, SimpleRoots SimpleLiving, and Indiana Jones. I am so excited to do this playlist. I can tell you that after the holidays, my craft area definitely needed some organization. So I know that crafting, you kind of get things everywhere all the time, stuff doesn't get put away, and hopefully some of these ideas can help you implement and use the storage in a way that's going to help you keep your area organized. I hope that's what it does for me, and I hope that we all get to see some great ideas on this playlist today. I know that we're going to, and I know that I can definitely use some help in some areas. So, and I use the word craft room loosely. I have a craft area that I use, and I know not everyone gets to have a dedicated craft room, so hopefully some of my ideas will help in you'll be able to implement in your areas as well if you don't have a dedicated craft room. But I'm so excited for this, and I hope you are too. So if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. It really does help my channel. Comment below, let me know which project is your favorite. And as always, if you'd like to become part of the Paper Owl family, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell so you get notified every single time that I upload. And without further ado, let's get started. Hey everyone, so starting out, I've got these three bins that I got from the Dollar Tree. And what I did is I rolled my fabric to fit inside these bins. These are so nice. They're flexible, which I actually like. They're not super stiff, so I can fit lots of fabric in here. And I've just kind of sorted them into the different types of fabric, I guess, that I have. I've got colors and designs in the one bucket, and then some more lacy material the other one, and then more rough material in that third one. I store these under a little side table that's in my craft area. They fit perfectly underneath there, and it's so nice. I can see everything that I have, and I can just pull one out and grab what I need and put it back so easily versus having it tucked away. I had these in kind of like a chest before, and it was such a hassle. Next up, I've got these storage bins for the beads. So that first storage bin, it had a rise in the middle there, so I couldn't stack things on top of it because there was that bump in the middle. Now these are tool storage from the Dollar Tree and they're nice and flat, so I can stack these on top of each other, and it makes it so much nicer. So I'm basically just transferring here. I do have some other beads and things that I am going to organize in these as well. So I love that I was able to find these in the tool storage, and they just work so great for beads and different little tiny things that you may have in your craft area. So once I get these transferred over, I grab a couple other bins that I have some different beads, and I decide to take the packaging off. Packaging causes so much more clutter, or not clutter, but it takes up so much more space in your craft area. So one thing I recommend, if you're able to take things out of its package, or the majority of it out of its package, and it will just save so much space in your craft area. So you can see here I've got this bin of beads, and it's still got a lot of the tags and different things on there. And so I removed all of those, and I mean, you can just see it just takes up so much space, and it looks much nicer and clean and organized in the bins here. Both of those sizes are from the Dollar Tree. You can see one is a little bit smaller, and it was meant for beads, and the other one is that tool bench one. Next up, I've got some glitter and sequins, and I personally don't use a lot of glitter and sequins in my crafting projects, but I recently have started making tumblers, which requires glitter, so I wanted to organize these and make sure that I've got everything nice and put together. You can see it's kind of crazy. Again, I I want to refer back to the packaging. A lot of this stuff I still had in its original packaging, and it takes up a lot of space. And so, and I did get these bins at the Dollar Tree. What's nice is these white ones have the lid that stays on them and it just closes in on itself. And those black ones or gray ones have a lid where the handles come up and close on top, which is great. So you can see here, I've got it all organized now. I love the clear, even those black or gray ones you can see through. And I took it all out of its packaging. I put a little piece of tape on any that were open, and then just organized the sequence in one bin, glitter in another bin, and it just turned out so beautiful and so much nicer. You can see there's some extra packaging I took off from those. And then I have some seed beads and some beading that I'm going to start doing as a new project that I have not done before. So these are my seed beads all organized, and my beading materials. So the different wire and the different needles and that sort of thing. So that all goes in that bin, which is great. I love having those handles that pull up over. It's just a nice secure lid that way. This is one of my favorite items from the Dollar Tree to help with storage. You can use it in so many different aspects in your craft area, in your home, just in general. You can see I've got all of this paper. I do some paper crafting, and it fits so much paper. It is unreal how much paper I can get on this thing, and it's nice and sturdy. The paper's not like flopping over, getting bent. It stays up nice and straight, and you can just see all of the paper that this holds is just so amazing, and I love this tool for that. It just keeps things nice and organized. It has the dividers in there, and it's just, I'm hands down, one of my favorite organizing tools from the Dollar Tree. And again, here are some different stickers and stencils and like my laminating pouches and just kind of some miscellaneous craft items like that that I have. And I used, again, one of those from the Dollar Tree to organize these, and it just keeps them so nice. And you're able to just pull something out, put it back in. So easy and so simple, and a great organization tool. Next up, these vases. This one is from the Dollar Tree. The other one I did get at a thrift store, so it's a little wider. But I took all of my Chanel stems out of the their packaging and put them in here and kind of sorted them by color, which makes it look a lot nicer in your craft area. Anything you can put on display that ends up being almost decor is a great idea. And then I put all my little wooden pieces in here. So these are dowels, craft sticks. I've got little tiny wooden skewers in there. And so this is a great tool. Again, it kind of puts it on display in a nice way. They're all the similar color and that sort of thing. These bins I got at Michael's. I believe they were $3, and it's such a great deal. So this has some different mixed media stuff in here. So I have some chipboard. I've got my calendars that I use from the Dollar Tree for different projects. I've got corkboard in here, and then different various pieces of cardboard that I'll use in projects or paper crafting to help support things. And then a great thing is these fit the magazine holders. So I've got two magazine holders back there as well. And what I did is I organized some different mixed media in one of them, and then I have felt and foam in the next magazine holder. And I just separated those by putting them in a Ziploc bag. And they're a couple miscellaneous things. I put some googly eyes and some fuzz balls in there, or pom-poms in there. And then I have some extra packaging back here that I use to do so many things within my craft room. And so these bins turn out to work so well and to keep things so nice and neat and organized. I also use these to help with the different Dollar Tree signs that I have, and that sort of thing in another one of those bins. This was a little side desk organizer that I had, and I had so much stuff in here, you guys. I wanted to show you everything that I took out, and it was just so crazy and just getting so out of hand, and it was just so much. So I took everything out, and I'm cleaning it out. You can see I have that organizer as well. But I wanted to show you, I put everything in its place, and then these are the main things that I like to keep out. So like my scissors, some tweezers, your pen, pencil, marker, that sort of thing. And those are just the main things that I need to keep right at my desk. And that's it. The rest could have been organized and put away. I did not need all of that out. I did want to show you this organizer that I got as well. That's meant for like paper filing and storage. And I use it for some of my 12 by 12 paper pads. And this works out so great. I'm always looking for ways to store my paper, and anything I can find that is bigger and sturdier like that is great. This is another paper organizer, and this is nice because it is elevated as it goes up, so you can see all of the pads that you have. So, great paper organizer. And then I always keep a bin with like projects that I'm working on. So I've got a project that I've got the different elements I'm working on in that little bucket, and that way I can move it around or, you know, put it away if I work on a different project. But I try to only have one bucket filled. Here are my Dollar Tree signs and different wood products, you guys. This is so embarrassing. But this is what it looks like after the holidays and just kind of throwing things together and not keeping it organized. So I'm super excited to get this space cleaned up, and I hope that you guys don't judge me based on this, but it ends up looking great. So next up are these jars from the Dollar Tree. I absolutely love these. So you can see I've got the pit berry all wrapped up in those, and they fit. It fit great. It fit so many of them, which was amazing. I didn't like the brown lids, so I ended up painting them white, which I recommend if you ever find any containers or anything to store things and it's just a color that's turning you off, take it and just paint it. But these stack on top of each other. They're super sturdy. They're real glass. They just are gorgeous, especially once those lids are painted. It just made it a completely different piece for me. So I was so happy to find those. Next up, I've got this kind of wicker storage bin, and you can see here I've got a couple things layered on top, but they're in super easy baskets to take away. And then underneath, I've got my burlap and then various twines that I have. And I like to store these separate than my ribbons, and I will take them off their spools. You can see I've got all of these big spools, and I took a lot of them off there because it just takes up so much room and is so much more bulky than it needs to be. So I wanted to show you that you don't, you know, again, with the packaging, if you're able to take stuff out of its package or off of its packaging, and it can save so much space. So I had a little tiny bin with lace, and then one bin with the raffia there, and that's it. I'm able to close this and kind of keep it nice and tucked away, but still very easily accessible. Another great, I guess it's not a hack, but another idea that I like to implement is taking these little tiny 2x3 frames and writing out stuff that you're going to store things in, and then attaching these to your bins. And it just makes the bins look so much more high end and so much more put together. And then of course you're labeling things, so everything has a home. And you guys, once everything has a spot to go in your space and you're able to implement that, it will keep you so much more organized, and it just makes your space that much nicer. So I love using these as labels for any wicker bins or the bigger bin items. Another great option is like the chalkboard tags that Dollar Tree carries. So you can see I took the little frame thing off the back there. You don't have to do that. Next up, I've got some of this eucalyptus oil from the Dollar Tree, and then one of their giant XXL bags. And this is from a pillow that I was no longer using, And so before I store it away in these big bags, I like to use some of the essential oils and put a little bit on there so that it keeps it nice and fresh and smelling good when I take it out. And even when I make pillows or anything with this fluffing stuff, I usually like to add some essential oils just to make it smell nice and fresh. So I love doing this. And instead of keeping like some old pillows stored around, you can use these big bags. I kind of squish them down to make sure all the air is out as much as I can, and it works out well. Next up, I do have a lot of moss and different moss items. And so I like, you can see the packaging there again. I like to put them in Ziploc bags. I feel like it helps keep them a little bit nicer, and then stuff's not falling out of an open package and that sort of thing. So this I definitely recommend doing with any of your moss bags or items. So I got them all kind of put together how they needed to be, and then some of the bigger bags that hadn't been opened yet, I decided not to put in Ziploc bags yet. So I got those organized how they needed to be, and it just looks so much nicer. And then I wanted to show you guys kind of how I had some of my ribbon before. Now, this is actually an old shoe rack, and I converted it into some craft space storage. So you can see my laminators there, and then I've just got ribbon kind of thrown about here, and it's not the most pretty or the most conducive to being accessible and using it. So I love this hack. So these are bins from the Dollar Tree, and I love these. These are actually not a Dollar Tree brand. They're very sturdy, but any of the Dollar Tree bins that have any of the cutouts like this, you can do this with. So I took one of their dowel rods, one that was long enough so it had ends sticking out on, the ends were sticking out on both sides. And I put like ribbon next to each other, like colors, so that it just made it look a little bit nicer. And that's another thing you can do is make sure you're putting like colors together and like shapes and sizes, and that's going to help make things look just a lot more aesthetically pleasing as well. And I feel like that makes you want to keep things looking that way. So I put as many as I can fit on there comfortably, and then I continue to add more. So what was great about this is I ended up being able to fit, I think, 26 spools of ribbon in this little bin. Like, granted, these are like the smaller spools of ribbon, but nonetheless, like, that is just absolutely amazing to me. And this, you can see on my craft mat, this is not a huge bin by any means. So it really was great that you could fit that many on there. And one thing I like to do is, you can see with these loose pieces where it's been open, I take just a tiny bit of hot glue and I tuck that down. I decided to put dark blue on that ribbon in case I couldn't remember it was dark blue. But you can see I've got it nice and full in there. It didn't fit an additional third dowel, so I just put some loose ribbon in. These I didn't need to put a dowel ribbon in because our dowel rod, because they already were big enough, it wasn't going to matter. So you could even like stack these on top of each other. They're, I mean, just such great bins. So I also take some of the Dollar Tree wooden trays and added my extra ribbon onto those. And that was a nice way to just kind of keep them all in place and organized. I did have this, I wanted to show you this thing I had with, which is a ribbon holder, but it was keeping everything closed. You can see it has a lid there, and I wasn't looking able to look at all my ribbon and utilizing what I had. So this is now what the same spot looks like, and it is just so much better. I can just see things more easily. Everything's more accessible. I know exactly what I have and if I want to use anything, and I still am able to keep my laminator on there, which I'm really happy about. So but everything's super accessible, and I just love those bins. Next up, I love this idea. This is an old shoe organizer. So I believe it had 10 spots for shoes. And what I did is I just took all of my florals and I stuck them in there. So these are my yearly florals. So my Christmas florals go in my Christmas stuff. So this is my any other time of the year florals. But I stuck like florals in with like florals in each bin. So if I had a lot of eucalyptus or lamb's ear, then I would stick those in a bin and, you know, et cetera, et cetera. And then I do have one large flower bin that I keep on the ground for my really long stems. So I've got a few really long stems that aren't going to fit in that shoe organizer. So you can see I keep those on the floor so that they have a home and they have a place to be and they're not just kind of thrown aside. Again, that's keeping everything in its place or everything having a place to be. And then I have all my moss sitting right next to them. So this is kind of like my floral area. Next up, I love this idea. This is a laundry basket. It's just like a, you know, the sides are flimsy or whatever, but I keep my extra fluff in there and then some extra rolls of wrapping paper and my brown paper, my brown craft paper that I use on projects. And I love having this. It's just a nice way to organize it for me. And then I have all of these different utilities, and I had them just kind of in different spots and in a bin and whatever. And so I had this desk organizer and decided I would try and utilize that. And this turns out so great. I feel like a lot of us ended up having some of these desk organizers laying around. If not, if you've got like even a couple old cans and one of the Dollar Tree napkin holders, you could do something very similar to this. So I just kind of stick everything on here with like things next to each other. So I keep all my hole punches next to each other. I've got a couple staplers. I put those next to each other. You can see the scissors all together. And it just makes it look so much nicer. And then I have a spot and a command center for just these kind of ancillary tools that I might need. So they're all together in one space. And if I need to go for something, I know exactly where I need to go and it should be. So it just fits so many things and I was so happy with it. So I love the way that this turned out. It makes me happy. All right, next up, I'm using one of these Dollar Tree file folders, and then they're index tabs that come in a pack of 8, and you can see I've got my receipts right there. So the one thing, I'm using a paper pad from Michaels that was on clearance for like $4.97. So with those index dividers that are there, they don't quite fit the file holder. And so if I put them in by themselves, there's a chance that the receipts are going to get pushed into a different area than I want them to. So I want to add this 12 by 12 scrapbook paper so that the index file extends the full length of the file folder so that the receipts don't have a chance of intermingling with each other. I hope that makes sense. So basically I just trace the index divider, and then I tape that on so that some of the paper is hanging out of the other end to make sure it fits nice and snug in that file folder. And I love the way this turned out. I really need to start keeping track of my receipts this year and stay really organized that way. And so I basically just do that to all 8, and then I add my titles in there and put my receipts in. And this is just such a great way. Everything has a place. So I get that organized, and then it's nice and slim, and I'm able to put it pretty much anywhere I want where it can just be like nice and tucked away. It's not taking up a lot of room, and it's easy to manage. So I don't have everything all over in crazy places. It's in this one nice file folder, and I don't have to worry about it. And they're so cute. I love these. I also use them for extra scrapbook scraps, our scrapbook paper scraps, for different paper pads. So again, I want to review this paper holder. I just am so in love with how much paper that it holds and that I've organized underneath here. You can see I've got an empty slot there, and that's another important thing, you guys. Keep spaces empty. Not everything has to be full. I've organized some different paper scraps that I've got there, and utilizing as much desk space as I can. Again, with the paper organization, I love these file holders to organize my large paper pads. It just makes it so much nicer, especially the one right next to it that elevates each paper pad so you can see exactly what you're dealing with. Again, if you can see things and put them on display, it just makes it so much easier to know exactly what you have. And then keeping different bins for projects that you have, that you're doing. Right now, if you're like me, you end up starting one or two projects at a time. It's just gonna happen. And then my little floral area over here, I just love how beautiful this looks. It just makes my heart happy. And again, if you can put any of your stuff on display that looks pretty, I know a lot of the crafting stuff we use is just gorgeous. So anything that you can put on display that's gonna make your craft room just a little bit brighter and nicer, do it. And then this I want to show utilizing your vertical space. So I've got a paper holder, and then on top of there I put a little acrylic box from the Dollar Tree, another riser, and then added some Dollar Tree bins at the top for storage. Again, this is that crate that we went over that has this couple magazine racks in the back, and I just love how much space that this gives me for all of my different mixed media things that I need. So I love those bins. If you come across them, I know Walmart carries them as well, and they are just, they're so inexpensive and they're so durable and they hold so much and you're still able to see a lot. These are the little drawers from the Dollar Tree, and I love these. You can stack them on top of each other and still pull the drawers out. You can glue them for more stability if you like. And then of course our chenille stems, our little wood products, and then these little bins from the Dollar Tree hold some paper clips, some push pins, and then I also made this riser where I tucked it together with some zip ties, and I made a little landing there for it. And this is an old CD rack, you guys, that I put my paper pads on. So there's some extra paper storage underneath, but you can see that CD rack, and it just worked out so great. There are my painted lids, looking so beautiful. And then, of course, utilizing as much vertical space as possible. There's another one of those Dollar Tree dividers, and then all of my bins, which I've tried to label as many as I can. I'm in the process of still doing some of that, but it just, everything has a home and is in its place. This is one of my favorite items to do that I've done, and this is my wreath holder. I took a broomstick from the Dollar Tree. I took a couple of their shower hooks and some twine, and I added it to this, oh my goodness. to the rack here, and it allows me to have so much hanging space for my wreaths, because I like to do wreaths and I'm gonna have a lot on hand and I don't want them to take up a lot of storage space on my wall. So be able to hang them here and then to just take that broom handle out and slide them off as I need them works out so amazing. The S hooks I have on the end there, you can always use to do something like this and hang buckets off of for additional storage as well. But this works out so well and you're able to utilize so much space. Another great item is actually the ring phone holders from the Dollar Tree. And I put those on the wall with some S hooks and some Dollar Tree baskets. And this is a great way to utilize wall storage space as well. I love this idea and it works out great. They actually hold a decent amount of weight. I mean, I wouldn't put like a 5-pound item in here, but they hold a lot. So I'm really happy with that. If you haven't seen before, I have another craft room storage video where I make this craft storage, these craft storage bins right here, but you can see all the different things you can store in here. I've got my washi tape, I've got some ribbon, I've got some various adhesives that I use that I put in some Dollar Tree bins that I'm able to just slide in and out because I made a little shelving process there with just some dowel rods and then the little bins from the Dollar Tree. So I love this storage item. It's able to maximize some vertical space that I have. And then I wanted to show you one of these magazine holders that I store a lot of my wood words and metal words in, and it just is nice and slim. I love that. Here's some more paper storage. And then again, my fabric down below, which I still am so in love with. It's just nice and grab and go. I've got a bookshelf here with a couple bins at the bottom that I store some of my paper crafting items in, and it's just so pretty to look at, and I just love it so much. Again, make it look nice. Make it look how you want it to look and what's going to make you happy. Again, here are some of those wicker bins that I used the frames on for labels, and it just works out so nice. I like to keep tea and candy items around for gifting, and so that's what I have in there. But I've got some of my blank wood items, and then some florals that I keep here if they shed a lot or more delicate than I want them to be put in the other area. I've got some bins here for my yarn and my jute cording, and this works out so well. I'm able to just pull those out and see what's inside, and it just works out great. I love that. And again, maximizing your vertical space. Another great trick is to use one of the Dollar Tree paper towel holders. I've just put that with some push pins, and I've got the Dollar Tree hula hoop sitting on there. You can make this more secure and hang some wreaths on there as well if you'd like. And this is a storage bin that I got from Michael's. It stores my vinyl, and then it has some ribbon storage on the side, which I really love. I also added some additional storage. You can see all the signs are nice and clean there as well. On the side, I put some command hooks to hold my Cricut mats, and this works out so great. And I've got another storage bin right next to it where I put some nails to have some hanging storage on the side there, so you're really utilizing so much space. And you know, trying to have like matching bins or things that are going to make you happy really helps. And then again, I have an empty space here to add some things if I need to, and that's really key. Thank you guys so much for watching, and happy